We find ourselves at a critical moment for both vendors and partners striving to go to market with a unified AI strategy. We know nearly a quarter of partners are implementing AI solutions, according to research done by CRN's parent company. But when we're talking about something some are calling revolutionary, is that enough? I'm joined now by Cyril Belikoff of Microsoft to talk about the latest AI developments and what you could be missing. Cyril, thanks so much for joining us today. Would you mind just quickly introducing yourself for our audience?
Hey, it's great to be here again. My name is Cyril Belikoff, and I work at Microsoft, and I'm responsible for our Azure and industry go-to-market marketing here globally. So it's good to be here again.
Thank you so much for taking this time to speak with us today. We all know the phrase generative AI. It's everywhere, right? But what we're hearing from partners is they're still unclear on how to successfully implement and monetize it. Microsoft, clearly a leader in this space. I just want to know about some key customer trends you're seeing, and then also from a larger perspective. What industries are making the biggest advancements, and could you maybe share some success stories?
There are four areas where we see transformation happening with AI. And whether you pick industry A or industry B or size of customer, it really doesn't change. And so those four areas are first, customer engagement, and that's really about enhancing the self-service and personalization experiences for customers. Then employee experiences themselves. So how do we help internal employees be more productive? How do we help them leverage AI in their daily lives? And then reinventing business processes. That's about reshaping things like supply chain and process automation. And then finally, bending the curve on innovation. In research and development, product and engineering teams, where we can give them deeper insights, faster analysis, and turn over the business quicker. And so we're actually seeing quite a lot of trends across all industries. And so to pick out one would be probably doing a disservice of the others. But I'll pick two customers as an example that we've seen. The first in the retail side is Choice. Choice are a great retail customer, and they used standard cameras to do anonymized analysis of where their customers were walking around their store. And so, of course, with privacy, they anonymized that information. But this is the story of the breakfast burrito. So Choice actually noticed that where their customers were walking, and they changed the location of their burrito and learned that customers actually bought burritos outside of breakfast. And they landed up doubling their sales of burritos. And now they're applying that across all their line items in their store. And the other one I use is Atrium Health, healthcare company, and they applied AI to their practitioners, their doctors, and their nurses, and they really allowed for their doctors to have much more of an engaging conversation with their patients and not be caught up in taking notes or sending actions on, and leverage AI to capture notes, learn from it, and then after the fact, have the nurse and the doctor leverage those notes to take action. So lots of great examples out there and lots going on in the industry.
Yeah, some really fun examples and also some absolutely crucial examples for our society. We know that CRN recently ran an article about all of the investments Microsoft is making in AI to make all of this happen. Why is AI also a crucial investment for partners, and how can they monetize it?
The first thing to just acknowledge is that, yes, we have these great investments in AI, and AI is really driving the next wave of innovation, like we mentioned, across all industries. But it's not in isolation from everything else in our customers' businesses. And so the AI needs some sort of application or some database or some infrastructure to reason over and to connect and enhance and improve. And so really we have to think about what else in our customers' infrastructure is there to help them with. And so do they need to migrate infrastructure or databases to the cloud so that they can reason over it? Do they need to create analytics experiences? Do they need to modernize some of their customers' experiences or applications? And so AI really sits at the center of everything in the cloud. And it's pulling through everything in the cloud. So it's great for all of us and our partners to think about how AI is pulling through everything else in the cloud and the money's to be made there. You know, the classic example that we use, it's Windows Server, SQL Server, and Linux, is large on-premise estates still with our customers. And like I mentioned earlier, you can't reason over that data and infrastructure unless it's in the cloud. So helping our customers migrate and modernize that infrastructure and then apply AI to it, lots of opportunity. And so plenty work to do for all of us, but also plenty opportunity.
And you spoke to this a little bit already, but it is so crucial, just like any other technology, to have AI tools that are optimized to integrate with other solutions in a customer's tech stack. This has evolved and changed the capabilities there so much even over the past few months. Can you speak to how products have evolved?
Yeah, that's a great question. We've seen a lot of developments and a lot is happening on AI, and we're focused on really ensuring that our partners come along with us and understand our evolving strategy and the products related to that. You know, at Build recently, we announced, three areas of investment: Microsoft Copilot, Copilot and AI Stack, and then Copilot Plus PCs. And these three categories are really the breadth of the investments that we're making and that our partners can use with their customers. So Microsoft Copilot is really about the Microsoft 365 Copilot and how that helps individual productivities. And we announced how Copilots will be available for teams. So teams can invite a Copilot to conversations and meetings that can help them in their daily work. The Copilot and AI stack, that's really the stack that we use to build our own Copilots. We're making that available to customers and partners to go and build their own AI experiences using the same technology, development tools, and experiences that we use ourselves. And so we made a ton of announcements recently, particularly around things like OpenAI's 4.0 and 4.0 mini models, breakthrough multimodal models across voice, video, text inputs, and outputs. Our own models with Phi, Meta made announcements with their Llama models, and then all the experiences that we provide around those models to around for deployment, decision-making around which models, management and optimization of it. We made announcements around Fabric itself, Fabric with real-time intelligence so that you can apply AI to real-time data coming off whatever data feeds you have in milliseconds. And so that's really a game-changing experience for our customers. And then things like security. Security is job number one for all of us, and so we're making huge investments there. And then the final area I mentioned was Copilot Plus PCs. This is a new category of PCs, very interesting category where we embed an AI chip or NPU into the PC so that it can handle the workloads for AI without taxing the core processing units or graphics units. So AI will be natural with this new wave of PCs. And again, with Windows 10 end of life in the next 18 months or so, it's a great opportunity for partners with PC refreshes with these great new Copilot Plus PCs. So lots of new technology, but lots of opportunity for partners.
Hearing so much excitement from partners about these AI PCs, so thank you so much for sharing that. We're getting close to time, but I have a couple more questions. So what is Microsoft doing to help partners accelerate their customers' AI ambitions?
You know, we're focused in sort of three areas. First is helping partners skilling. We executed AI workshops and boot camps almost to 700,000 learners in the last 12 months, and we will continue to accelerate that with the demands and the needs from partners around getting skilled. We have AI partner training days, which are in-person experiences, and we'll continue to do those as well. So lots of opportunities to get skills and get skilled up. We then have go-to-market materials, whether it's sales decks, campaigns in a box for the marketers. So really across 11 languages for all of our partners to use. And then finally, incentives. With Azure Innovate and Azure Migrate and Modernize, we had over 10,000 projects delivered and paid out to partners in the last 12 months. So lots of opportunity for continued work there where you engage customers for either AI innovation or the migration opportunity that we spoke about earlier. So lots of resources, lots of skilling, and of course, lots of incentives for partners as we move forward. So take a look at our website. All of these resources that I mentioned are right up there. So thanks a ton.
There was so much you talked about today that I didn't know about yet. I'm personally so excited about Copilot, leading a creative team myself. So there's definitely a use case for everyone. I really appreciate you.
Thanks a ton. Thanks for your time.